Hi, I'm Dennis Morgan, and I'm here at the Descase Manufacturing Facility in Goodlettsville, Tennessee. And this is where all the magic happens, where Descase manufactures all of their products, including breathers and fluid handling systems. And in the fluid handling line, they manufacture filter carts, T-stands, and a product we're going to talk about today, vacuum dehydration systems. Let's go take a look. I'm here today with our vacuum dehydration system. This unit right here happens to be our 10 gallon per minute vacuum dehydration system, our VAC-10. I want to just take a couple minutes and talk a little bit about the key features and benefits of this unit here. First of all, it is a 480 volt three-phase system. That's standard on all of our units. This is our vacuum tower here. One of the key features of our vacuum tower is our permanent dispersion media. The biggest point of the permanent dispersion media is that it's stainless steel, never needs cleaned, never needs serviced, never needs replaced. It is a 65 square foot per cubic foot media, meaning that for each cubic foot of this media is 65 square feet of surface area. And the reason that's important, surface area, is when the vacuum is acting on the oil. The oil needs to be in a very thin layer in order for the vacuum to be effective at removing that moisture. Another key feature of our VAC-10 system, or all of our vacuum dehydration systems, is our vacuum pump. This is a dry running claw pump. Importance again, very low maintenance. And also, this pump is capable of achieving 37 torr, or 28 and a half inches of mercury on the gauge. That very low vacuum level is essential for efficient and effective water removal from lubricating oil. Also, some key features of our control panel. First of all, we have a phase monitor and phase reversal switch. For many of you who are in maintenance and have had to change wires around in order to reverse the rotation of a machine, our units come standard with a phase monitor, phase reversal switch, allowing you just to change the phase with the selection of the switch. We also have main power disconnect, several alarms, including high condensate, a change filter indicator, high tower oil level indicator, high pressure, high system pressure indicator, and low flow indicator. A key feature of our control panels is the ability to vary the speed using a variable frequency drive. A variable frequency drive is controlled with this knob right here, which is a 0 to 100% knob. One of the really nice things about the variable frequency drive used by Descase is that it is a 1-for-1 variable frequency drive, meaning that when the selector knob is at 50%, the unit is running at a true 50% speed. Also have an integrated heater controller and a heater selector. For noisy situations where it's hard to hear the pumps running, we have indicator lights to let the operator know that the vacuum pump and the discharge pump is running. Other key features of the VAC system come standard, the discharge filters. These are either a 6x18 or 6x36 high efficiency pleated microfiberglass filter elements. Also another standard feature, the water pot or condensate tank. This is to capture any liquid water that recondenses during the dehydration process. As part of the water pot or condensate tank system, a standard feature is the auto drain system. This auto drain system activates when the water pot fills about half full of water, allowing the system to run continuously. Other features of the Descase vacuum dehydration system include an automatic flow control system. That automatic flow control system is regulated by a valve inside the chamber. It is a float level globe valve that automatically controls the amount of oil coming into the vacuum chamber. The way that works, the valve portion of the unit is here in this side, and on this side is a float ball that's moving up and down, controlling the amount of oil coming into the vacuum chamber. Also in this area here are all of the controls and gauges for this unit. We have the vacuum gauge. This is indicating the level of vacuum inside the vacuum chamber. Immediately behind it is the vacuum control valve. This allows the operator to control the level of vacuum inside the vacuum chamber. And then there's a non-desiccant breather that is preventing any particulate from getting into the vacuum chamber. Additionally, down below, we have the discharge pump pressure gauge, and we have the filter change indicator gauges, or pressure differential gauges. These indicate to the operator when he needs to change the discharge filters. Additionally, they include switches on the back that will activate an alarm on the control panel at 40 PSI differential. Also included standard on all of the Descase vac systems is sample ports, a pre-filter and post-filter sample port.